Hey, BiggerPockets Nation, it's Brandon Turner, author of the book on rental property investing, landlord with over 500 rental units, and host of the BiggerPockets podcast. You know, this is a troubling time full of uncertainty in the world, right? However, some things are really certain, and one of those things is that a lot of people are not able to work due to the social distancing we're engaged in right now. And as a landlord, many of these unemployed workers are renting from us. So, as landlords, what do we do? Of course, now if you're not a landlord and you're watching this, you're probably wondering, what's the big deal? Just do the nice thing and don't make anyone pay rent for a while. But we know that that is not necessarily possible, right? I mean, unless the government changes something drastically, we aren't gonna just suddenly be able to stop paying our mortgage payment. We're not gonna be able to stop paying our taxes, the insurance, and the other expenses that are needed to run a property. And despite what the general population thinks, most landlords are not rich, greedy, multinational corporations with billions sitting in the bank. Most landlords are people just like you and me, people who, whether by accident or on purpose, ended up with a few rental properties and are trying to manage them while also working a job or running a business. And most will not be able to pay the bills on their properties long term without getting rent from our tenant. So, what do we do? Well, I can't answer for you necessarily, as we all have unique situations, but at least I can share with you the exact strategy that my wife and I have come up with for our personal rental properties. And hey, do me a favor, if you find this video helpful, don't forget to click that little thumbs up button so that more property owners will get this information. All right, so here is our 5-point plan for dealing with late or missing rent. Number one, have a plan. It's a kind of a summary point here, but it needs to be made. Whether in the Wild West or while dealing with a tenant, shooting from the hip is generally a terrible idea. Making decisions on the fly usually results in bad decisions being made. So step one is to commit to having a plan written down for how you are going to deal with this issue. Because for most property owners, this is not a question of if, it's a matter of when. Now, maybe this video itself can become a plan that you follow, but even if you do something entirely different from what I'm about to say, just be sure you are prepared. This way, you won't be shooting from the hip when that dreaded phone call comes in from the tenant who just lost their job. All right, step number two, empathize. Now, the remainder of the steps on this video, 3, 4, and 5, they're more concrete, but I wanna make sure we address this. Tenants are people, and they're going through a remarkably scary time. Perhaps maybe a worse time than you're going through because you're probably a little more financially educated and have more of a foundation of finance than many of your tenants do. So before anything else, listen to them. Understand what they're going through. Talk with them. Empathize. We're all in this together. So let's remember to be human and keep people before profit in our discussions. Now that said, we still need rent. We can't survive financially without it. So that brings me to step number three. Step three, explain that rent is still due. For as long as there have been tenants and landlords and bills to be paid, there's a super interesting piece of human behavior at play here. People will pay the bills that give them the greatest consequence of not paying. In other words, most people financially struggle to pay their bills, but they can pay some of their bills, if not all their bills. This is why late fees are so important when landlording, because when the choice is between paying rent and buying a flat screen TV, well, the late fee and the threat of eviction tips the scale towards that money being used to pay rent. But today we're not really dealing with flat screen TVs, are we? But the principle still applies. Likely, your tenant is gonna have to make some serious decisions on what bills get paid and which ones don't. That is why after talking with a tenant and empathizing with them, I believe it's still important to let them know the rent is still due. And as I'm sure you've heard, evictions are being suspended in most areas in the US right now. The ability to issue a late fee might also be banned soon. Your tenant very well might assume that this means the need to pay rent is also being suspended, and it's your job to inform them otherwise. Even if you can't evict right now, legally, it doesn't mean that they still don't owe the rent. It doesn't mean that you won't evict later when the courts do open back up again. You don't need to be a jerk about this, but let them know that you have a mortgage payment, you have bills to pay, and that them paying is going to be vital for keeping the property. All right, step number four, give your tenant their options. Look, once you've explained that the rent is still due, now is the time to help the tenant navigate this difficult time. You know, we plan to do this by giving them their options, as they may be unaware of the different ways that they could come up with the rent. First, we plan to keep an eye on programs that the government is designing to help individuals, especially tenants. This is a rapidly changing time, so we're gonna keep a close eye on the assistance programs. Now, right now, there is a very real possibility that the government is gonna issue cash payments to every adult American, and you know, that could help quite a bit. But even if they don't, there might be a local, like, or local programs, state programs, or other federal programs that could help. Also, we are gonna offer other suggestions as well. For example, maybe they could borrow money from a relative, or maybe could the rent be paid via credit card? In fact, to help where we can, we plan to offer to pay the fee associated with using a credit card. And that could be up to $30, $40, $50. Now would be a good time for you to get set up on a rent collection system that has the ability to take a credit card. Companies like Venmo, PayPal can handle that, as well as property management software like Buildium, AppFolio, or Cozy. All right, step number five. The emergency rent deferral plan. Okay, this is where I hope my tenants don't watch this video, because I don't really want the tenant knowing that this is an option yet. If I brought this up at the beginning for tenants, most everyone in the world would jump at it. Because remember, humans will naturally pay the most pressing bill. So I need them to know that rent is still incredibly high on their priority list. So step five, though, is our worst case measure that'll only be mentioned to tenants when they don't pay their rent, not when they call and say they're not sure they'll be able to. We'll still let the tenant know that the rent is due on the first, we'll give them their options I just mentioned, and even still issue a late notice to the tenant if they miss paying rent. But what if they really have exhausted all their options and they just can't pay the rent, and they're a good tenant, especially if they're a good tenant? This is where we will introduce the tenant to our emergency rent deferral plan, or ERDP. And because we followed step one of the video, we have a specific plan in place to deal with this inevitable situation. And having this documented plan in place shows the tenant that this is not us winging it, but we have a system that can handle this. We're professional. But more on that system in just a second. First, there's a really important question we're gonna ask each tenant before we introduce this plan. How much can you pay toward your rent? Chances are, even if they can't pay all of their rent, they can probably pay some of their rent. Maybe their rent is $1,000 a month and they can pay $300 toward their rent. Well, we're gonna accept that $300 and move on to the ERDP. Now, what is the ERDP? Simply put, the ERDP allows the tenant to opt into a payment plan for their rent over the following 10 months. The ERDP is an addendum to their lease that gives them the ability to take their rent and pay it in equal portions for the next 10 months. Now, that begins the second month after enacting. It basically gives them an extra month before the increased payment begins. So for example, let's say that we've gone through all of this, but the tenant simply cannot make the April 1st rent. They owe $1,000 in rent, and because we asked what they can put toward it, they are able to put $300 towards the remaining, towards what they owe. So the remaining $700 becomes like 70 bucks a month. That gets added to their rent beginning June 1st. So starting June 1st, now not May 1st, and I'll explain why in a second, they will pay $1,070 per month in rent until the following March. Now, why not start the payment next month? Simply because I have a strong suspicion that this is not gonna end quickly. 1 month deferral may not be enough time to get them back on their feet. So we're gonna wait an extra month before adding that extra payment. Now, furthermore, it is our company policy that during this time, a tenant will be allowed to use this ERDP twice. Of course, we're not gonna tell them that immediately, the same reason we want to, you know, we're not gonna tell them about the program to begin with. We want them to work through steps one through four first. Rent has to remain a priority, but eventually we will let them do 2 months. Now, if after those 2 months are still unable to pay, the tenant may just need to move. Now, this is completely uncharted territory we find ourselves in today. I'm not gonna lie to you and tell you I know exactly what we're gonna do then, and I know what the future holds. But here's the deal, the government can't forever stop evictions and stop making people pay rent, or allow them not to pay rent, but continue to force mortgage payments and foreclosures. I mean, otherwise every landlord in the country is eventually gonna go bankrupt, or all these banks are gonna end up owning the, like, millions of properties. So somewhere, something's gonna have to give. If this social distancing, job loss, and potential economic meltdown continues, we're gonna make new rules as it happens. My guess is that the government will offer more and more programs to attempt to help, because remember, you and I are not alone in this. Everyone is trying to figure this out. And we will. Humans have an incredible ability to figure stuff out when the night is darkest. We will get through this. We will survive. We will emerge stronger. Now, I hope this video shed some light on what I'll be doing in my personal rental portfolio to handle potential rent issues in the near future. Maybe you'll be doing something a little bit different. And hey, that's great. You know, we're all just figuring this out. I encourage you to share your thoughts below the video and let us know what your plan is. And perhaps together, we can help the world, both tenant and landlord, move forward financially successful. Remember, if this video was helpful, please hit that like button below the video, the thumbs up, and share this with somebody you think would benefit from hearing it. And if you're a landlord and you're looking for more advice on managing rental properties, my wife and I wrote a book called The Book on Managing Rental Properties. It's full of tactics, tools, and strategies for navigating the messy world of landlording. You can even get it at a library, so if you don't want to buy it, just read it. And perhaps now is a good time to get some reading in anyway, to brush up on your skills. Because remember, the economy cannot stop your work ethic. It cannot stop your drive. It cannot stop your quest for self-education, self-improvement, and personal growth. For BiggerPockets.com, my name is Brandon Turner, signing off. Big time.